What's good, YouTube? Ghost Fujino back again with another My Hero Academia episode reaction. Last week was jam-packed. We saw a lot of action between that boy Dabi and my man's Endeavor. I don't know. I think they might be related because Dabi's out here calling him by his government name. Like it's casual out here. Like regular people call him Endeavor, but he's out here being like NG Todoroki. Like, who are you, bro? Like there's something going on there. We found out that Hawks is also, you know, kind of trying to play both sides. He's, you know, team hero, but his task is to infiltrate the villain, the League of Villains, and kind of see what's going on there. And they're basically trying to catch the League of Villains between like both sides, right? So like they got an insider filling in for them, and they also got the powerful heroes on the outside, and they're just trying to crush them basically. So Hawks is a good dude. He's a good dude because I was kind of skeptical when he kind of set it up with Dabi to bring the when he kind of played with Dabi to bring the Nomu for Endeavor to fight. I was like, hey, which team are you on, man? Which team are you on? But he's a good youth. We saw a little bit more of Endeavor's family situation. And as expected, he's struggling because, you know, up until this season, he was a deadbeat, a full-on deadbeat dad. But yeah, like his kids are kind of talking to him, and he, after a conversation, yeah, with All Might, he's like, hey, man, if I'm going to be a good hero, if I'm going to be the number one hero, it starts in the family. And it's fair, you know, so that's kind of what's going on there. And last but not least, we kind of touched into the origin of One For All. Saw Deku having a dream, and then we saw One For All and his brother All For One kind of fighting, seeing how All For One was recruiting villains like it was nothing. He was out here like Oprah handing out quirks, you know what I'm saying? Like, you get a quirk, and it was easy as hell. He was just kind of playing with their insecurities and saying, hey, you know what, you got a buck tooth, what if I give you a power and I fix that buck tooth for you? And then they're all like, yeah, for sure. So, but hey, it's cool that we got to see how, you know, One For All was invented, because at the end, it's implied that All For One gave him that power, and it was confirmed by, you know, people in the comments. Shout out to the people in the comments. But yeah, I'm looking forward to this week's episode. Hopefully a lot of action, and without further ado, let's hop into it. Damn, so All Might never actually spoke to the first, but then Deku gets to speak to the first. That means this boy is special. But to be honest, he hasn't looked special in this show at all. But hey, if they're saying there's something special in the man, then so be it. Oh, yeah, so like, it's kind of like having mixing quirks makes him stronger. Okay. But then One For All is a singular quirk? I guess it's because people who get it usually aren't born with a quirk, right? That's just my thought. I love All Might, man. He's definitely my favorite in the show. And Dennis Endeavor. Endeavor might take that top spot. Class A versus Class B. It's going to be a brawl. Yeah, Bakugo Squad is elite, man. They came out dripping. Bruh, I don't know not one of these niggas. Who is that? Who are these people? What? Hey, bro. Nah, I remember the Iron Dudes because he fought Kirishima. I remember him. Who the fuck? Yo, this boy has all the tools to become a pro villain. Why would you become a hero? This man can brainwash people? Fam, you walk into a bank and you're like, put all the money in my bag. They can't say shit. I don't know. I'm just saying. You're trying to be a hero? That's the wrong job for you. It's kind of like someone who's like 6'3" and is trying to be like a farmer. Like, bro, you should be in the NBA. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's the same thing. Like, why are you trying to be a hero with a brainwashing ability? That's a pro villain. You would climb to the number one villain in a year. I don't know. I'm just saying. I like Shinso, though. Like, he's not friendly. And My Hero has a lot of friendly-ass characters. And he's not friendly, so I fuck with him. I actually mess with him. Yeah, this is cool and all, but I'm trying to see some real action, man. I'm trying to see some heroes versus villains type of action. I feel like they hit us with a training session every 5 episodes. It's kind of like, bro, episode 1 and now episode 3 is training. Like, where are the villains at? You got Dabi out on the loose. You got Nomu's out on the loose. Yes, sir. Deku and Mineta on the team. Deku and Mineta on the same team. That's what I like to see. That's what I like to see. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yo, I rate him because he was a man who wanted a shot, you know what I'm saying? Like, I think he was telling Deku like 2 seasons ago, like, bro, y'all got it easy. Y'all got easy quirks, y'all can make it to the league or the school. And then he's like, I had to work hard, he had to grind for this. And he's like, I made it to the beginning. Like, he hasn't made it yet. He's made it to the opportunity to make it. I love it. I actually like Shinzo. Like, he's a cool character. I don't know much about him, but he's a cool character. They came quick. They said, fuck stealth, we coming in straight from the front door. Guys, this episode was, I don't even know what to make of this episode, man. Nothing really went on. You know what I'm saying? Nothing really went on. Like, what did we really see? So it started with like a flashback. So like basically the ending of last week's, they kind of spun that again for 5 minutes this week. And then we get introduced to this guy called Shinso. He's cool. I rock with him. He's kind of like the quiet type go-getter. You know, he got it out the mud. Nothing came easy to him. And then now he's kind of, I guess, I don't know if he moved on to class 1B. Like, I'm not sure how it works. But basically, he leveled up. You know what I'm saying? Like, he leveled up. And he's participating in the training with class 1A and class 1B. And his power was sick. You know, like, I actually do remember him. Like, I remember his powers. OP as hell, you know, brainwashing people. Riddle me this, right? Why does this man want to be a hero? I'm just saying, if you got the ability to brainwash anybody, you would be a top villain. That's top 5, top 3 villains in the show right then and there. Why are you trying to be a hero? I don't know. Like, it's seems like he's in the wrong place, you know. If he becomes a hero, all I'm saying, he's going to suffer from imposter syndrome. He's going to be like, I ain't supposed to be here. That's all. Hey, that's all I'm gonna say. But as for the rest of class 1B, I didn't know any of them dudes, man. I didn't know anybody. They were out here putting out the panels like they always do with the quirks and everything. And then they're like, this guy, his name, his ability. I'm like, who? It's kind of like when you have those rappers that have a low-key new artist featuring on their song. And you're out here like, you're listening to a little bit of it. You can't recognize the voice. You're like, who? Or like when like an average NBA player drops like 20 points and then, you know, House of Highlights or the score post on, you're like, who? That was me this entire episode. They were showing class 1B and I was like, who are these mans, bro? But aside from that, nothing really went on. Like, we saw like a little bit of the first fight, you know, the team cornering Shinzo's team, and Shinzo just using his brainwashing ability to stop the bear guy. So like, honestly, the episode was kind of mid. You know, I'm gonna have to give this like a 6 out of 10 because I wasn't too impressed. I came in excited, but I wasn't too impressed. Let me know what you guys thought of the episode. If you guys enjoyed it, if you guys didn't, what do you guys think of Shinzo? Y'all think he should be a hero? I think he should be a villain. If I'm being completely honest, like he should go call Dabi real quick and be like, hey, you got a spot for me over there? You got a spot for him? He's trying to go to the Nets. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got room for me? Y'all got cap space? But yeah, like, honestly, episode was mid. Hopefully next week's is better. I'm always looking forward to these episodes. There's not much going on in terms of mainstream anime. You know, I'm still waiting on Vinland Saga. Vinland Saga is supposed to drop this month, but I haven't heard nothing. Bleach is supposed to drop this year, but I haven't heard nothing, so I'm still waiting. One thing I did want to talk about was what I will start watching soon, because a lot of shows have ended. So Attack on Titan wrapped up, Dr. Stone wrapped up, Jujutsu wrapped up, The Promised Neverland, even though they fumbled the bag and I stopped watching that dropped. So basically, I've had a lot of requests on some people want me to start watching. So I know JoJo is highly requested. I'm gonna check that out. I know One Piece, highly requested. I might check that out. Even though I did watch One Piece for a little bit, I stopped around the... It was definitely after the time skip, but I did stop after a while because One Piece is long as hell, man. One Piece is long as hell. But I might pick it back up, who knows? But definitely for now, stay tuned for Steins Gate. So I'm gonna check out Steins Gate. It's pretty short, but I hear it's a classic, it's goated. So I'm gonna check that out. It's only 24 episodes, so that's coming out on the channel real soon. And yeah, stay tuned. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know down in the comments below what you liked about this episode, what you didn't like. And please make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. It's been your boy, Ghost Pedrino, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.